We've converted this JPEG, a single shot image, into a 3D scene or a video that moves. And you could also do this on a vertical video as well. And we've done this on Canva. Join me. To access canva.com, and you're going to be selecting a video canvas. So I'm going to be using the landscape video format to do this tutorial. So you're going to either upload a photo or use a photo from Canva. If you are using a product photo, that's also such a good idea. We are going to be using this car photo that I found on Canva, and how we're going to start the process. We're going to do step by step, very simple, very easy to follow and to actually execute. Once you've added your image, you're going to right click and you're going to set it as a background. So the first step that we want to do is to separate the car to the background of the image. So that's fairly easy. You're just going to select the image so that you find the function that says edit photo, and you click on edit photo, and you're going to be using the background remover because we want the car to be taken away from the rest of the scene. This is a Canva Pro functionality, so if you would like to trial it with my link below, by all means do that. You will not regret that. So the car is separated. We're happy with the detail of the car. We're going to click on add page. That would be our step number two. We're going to add image again, and we're going to set the image as background. So what we want to do now is to remove the car so that we have the background on its own. So how you would do that, you would select the image and it would be highlighted in purple, and then you go again and click edit photo. This time we want to erase the vehicle so that we have just the scene. So we're going to select the magic eraser. Again, this is another Canva Pro functionality that you will only be using if you have Canva Pro, and you can trial it. I said that already. So now we've selected a brush size of 20. You can make the brush size bigger and smaller. It's up to you. You're going to brush over the vehicle to remove it from the actual image. So you're going to gently brush over the image and take off the car. Then the software will delete the image from our bigger image. I'm happy with that. So that it looks very misty-like and it's edited what we want. So that's perfect. And we have the car. We have the scene without the car. Next step is for you to go to your scene number one. Go copy the image of the car and place it on the second scene. So what I would do then, I would detach the image from background and then copy the image, go back to step two and place my image. I don't need this image anymore, so I'm going to delete it. I'm going to crop out the rest of the extra spaces on my car. So you could also use an BMW, a Mercedes-Benz. I wish Mercedes-Benz would call me and give me a car to do this for them. Anyway, and then you make the size of your car nice and big, and you place it on your scene, and beautiful, you have your image right there and then. So the third step is we're going to animate this car of ours, which is an element on its own. So you're going to select it and you're going to click on animate, and then you're going to create an animation of the vehicle. So you just select create an animation and you click your element and you move it like that. And if you're happy with the path, you click done. But I want to make it a little bit smoother. You can also make it a bit steady. I like steady more. Once you've made it steady or smooth, you could also adjust your speed. The orient element to path makes the topsy-tavy. So you can play around with the software and see. I'm having so much fun with this. Once you're done, you click on done and your car is moving. So let's have a look and see how it looks like. Oh, I love it. I love it. Perfect. So I like to add extras on my scenes in my work that I'm creating so that it brings the message across to whoever is watching my content. I always love to add sound wherever possible. So the car is moving, I'm just going to increase the scene size and make it like 9 seconds long. And then I'm going to go to audio. So I'm going to go and search for car sounds or car movement. And I'm going to press enter and I'm going to click on audio. And I'm going to be scrolling down to be listening to different kinds of audios until I find the exact one that fits the scene that I'm busy creating over here. So I found the one that says, there's one that says auto pass by two vehicles. When I clicked on this one, I loved it. It was perfect. So wherever your header is standing, that's where your music is going to be added to. So you can move it to the beginning of the scene and click once on the audio, and then your scene has the music or the audio that you've added on there. That seems a little bit long, so you could adjust it, make it 7. And then when you want to adjust the audio, you just click on audio adjust and then you move your audio like that. And that's pretty much it. That's your 3D scene. Next, to make our look and feel look really good, I'm going to press T for text and add text on my scene. So I'm going to fast forward this process. For the cherry, I want to make the scene even more attractive because this is such a nice misty kind of a video or a 3D scene. You can also always go and add mist on there. I did that and it looked so nice. You just click on mist and you look for different kinds of mists that you could add on the scene, like this one, and rotate it and drag it on the scene itself and duplicate that for the rest of the scene. And when we play it, it looks like this. Right? Let me know in the comments, you know, if you've enjoyed this tutorial. I certainly had fun creating this one. But once we're done, we're going to click on download and download our MP4. If you enjoy these animations, I did another cool one where we were animating a burger. You can go check it out. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you on the next video.